Okay. A few clarification. At this point, from here to there, I drop I. As someone asked, it's not because I can divide I both sides, because vector, that operation is not defined. Like, I cannot say that I divided by I is 1. No, this notation is not defined. So you cannot do that. The reason going to di from to there is not because of this, but because if you're looking at the again vector notation, then you can see the reason. Because what's the vector notation of I? If I write down in vector notation in three-dimensional space, yes, it's a 1 1 0 0 0. Yeah. So if you multiply this 1 0 0 here, plug in there, then this stuff becomes integration dx multiplied by 1 0 0 is equal to integration by dt gt dt. Is 1 0 0. So term by term should be equal to each other. So the other two terms are 0 0. First term, this times this, and this times this should be equal to each other. This is the one that I write. Okay. So this operation, unfortunately, is not, it's not defined. Okay. Now let's look at the example that when it's rotating coordinates is much convenient than the Cartesian fixed coordinates. Say that I have a pipe. Hollowed pipe. And this pipe here is connected to the electrical motor, so it rotates like this. Say theta dot is as a constant angular velocity. What number should I put? So 1 radian per sec. So about 57 degrees per second, and the angular velocity is constant, so angular acceleration, say that this is zero. Then you have a particle inside of this pipe, and since you are rotating, then this particle will travel towards the outside, towards the end of the pipe, right? Say that initial, this distance initially is half meter, and velocity initially, say that this velocity is zero. The time t equal to zero is zero. And say that this another remaining part of the pipe length is a half meter. And then I ask the, what would I ask? I ask the velocity, yes. When it exits the, maybe it flies like this direction, what's the velocity this could be? Right. And procedure is the same as before. First, I have to draw the free body diagram of this particle. So this is the rotating in the of it's this plane. So there's no gravitational effect. I ignore the gravitational effect. Also, I assume that there's no friction inside the pipe, between the pipe wall and this particle. So particle is here. So let's say this particle mass m is 1 kilogram. Then what kind of force is this particle experienced? Is there any force or not? Yeah? Hint is there is one force. Yeah? Oh, where's my glasses? There's one force. No, no, I said that this is rotating on this plane.
All right.
Therefore, gravitational effect is, I can ignore it. Because there's no movement in the up and down. Huh? We haven't learned the moment of inertia yet. But the moment of inertia is not a force. Huh? Centrifugal force. No, those are the force generated by the movement. But I ask that the pure force. Weight, that's the related to the gravity. Again, this is rotating on the horizontal plane. It doesn't move in this direction, so I can ignore that gravitational effect.
Is it acceleration?
Not the acceleration. I ask that, again, I ask that the pure force, not generated by some acceleration. That's a different thing. So some force would be generated by acceleration, but we'll see that example later, but not here. Yeah? That's again the caused by the movement. But I see it. You can see it. There's one force. Huh? No, force. Come on, force is pushing something. What is pushing this particle? Huh? Huh? What's that? Torque. We haven't learned torque yet. Yes? Huh? Mass? No, mass is not a force. you may lost because there's a lot of formulas. But if you see this, if I ask to probably the kindergarten students, they will answer it. Something pushing, something, one thing, one, yeah? Huh? 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 Don't know. Yeah, okay. So, this pipe wall pushing the particle. If this is the particle pipe wall, this wall push. When it rotates, it keeps pushing the particle. Yeah?
It's rotating about vertical axis like that, the pipe, or around horizontal.
No, it's like this, yeah. So the pipe rotating like this. Yeah, so this wall keep pushing the particle. Can you see it? No? 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 Yeah. I mean, okay, let me draw the particle a lot bigger. Then this pipe wall rotating this way, so instantaneously it travels this direction. Therefore, this side of wall will push this particle in this direction. Yeah? Yeah, so let me draw the free body diagram. This is the particle, and free body diagram is just one force here. Let's call it F force by wall. This is, of course, vector. There's no force in this direction, because I said that there is no friction between the particle and the wall. Therefore, no force in this direction, but the wall keep pushing the particle in this way to rotate. Can you feel it? No? Yes? I mean, if I ask the kindergarten student, what's pushing this mess inside? The pipe. So everyone agree? Now? Yes, so again, this perpendicular axis, there's no force in this direction. Because I assume that there's no friction between the particle and the wall. If there's a friction, there will be force. Or you could introduce, saying that there's some pressurized gas at the center pushing the particle outside, then there will be some force. Then it's like a cannon fired, cannonball fired. But at the moment, there's no friction or the firing gas. So this is the free body diagram. And then now, next thing is that you have to establish the coordinates. Then I'm going to use the rotating coordinates. So I put the origin here, again, at the center of the rotation. And because of the rotating coordinates, this is IB direction. JB is perpendicular to that. This is JB. So this is O origin. Because now I have this free body diagram and I establish the coordinates, then I can write down this Newton's second law, F, sum of F is m times acceleration. But in the rotating coordinates, so sum of FR IB plus sum of F theta, transverse direction, JB. There's no Z direction movement, so I ignore that. I didn't write the Z direction. M times IB acceleration part we wrote just in the previous class, which was, where is it? Okay, R double dot, this R double dot minus R theta dot square. R double dot minus R theta dot square plus JB direction, what is that? R theta double dot? No, I keep forget. Okay, R theta double dot plus 2 R dot theta dot. R theta double dot plus 2 R dot theta dot JB. Radial direction force, there's no force in that direction, this is zero. Transverse direction force, there's only one force, which is the generated by the pipe wall, so let's call it this F wall. R double dot, I don't know yet. R keep changing with time. R dot, I know. I said that this pipe rotates with a constant angular velocity, 1 radian per sec. So this guy here, R dot square, this is 1. Theta double dot is 0, because I said that angular velocity is constant. This R dot is 1. Let's write down now. So F wall JB is equal to M was, is it in 1 kilogram? Yes, 1 kilogram. So M is all 1. This is 1. This is 1. R double dot minus R IB plus 2 R dot JB. Okay, everyone's with me? I can write down again. Let's use the vector format. JB is 0, 1, 0. IB was 1, 0, 0. JB is 0, 1, 0. So this left hand side equals 0, F wall, 0. Let me make it clear that for this, for example, this IB 100 is different from the this I 100. It's different. So be careful. But in this case, everything is represented by the rotating coordinator. So I can safely use just the 100, 100, 100. So this side, first part R double dot minus R, and 2 times R dot times this first column 0 doesn't give you anything, so that's your first element. Second element, this times 0 is 0, 2 R dot is here, last part is 0. So these two vectors must be equal to each other. So first, from the first row, you got R double dot minus R is 0. Second row, you got 2 R dot is F4. So now I have to integrate this. To integrate this, this is second order in R, because R double dot. I need two initial conditions, initial position in R and initial velocity in R direction. So R0 at time t was 1/2 meter. Velocity at time t, I assume that this was 0. So let's solve the first equation. I replaced R double dot by dr dot by dt is equal to R. Again, it's the same as before. You multiply dt both sides, dr dot r dt. And then you put the integrate dr dot r dt. But if you do that, you're stuck here. You can go further from here, because I can integrate this side, left hand side, because this is just one integration by R dot, which will give you R dot if you integrate it. On the other hand, this side you cannot integrate, because you have to integrate by time, not R, but R is function of time. R is function of time, which you don't know. So you cannot integrate. This is actually the similar situation you end up for solving the first problem in the tutorial session. So what are you going to do? We need some trick. So instead of doing this, we do something else. Starting from here. So let me write down here again. Yes. Oh, because this R double dot from here, R double dot is R. It's coming from this equation. Okay, so we need a different trick to solve velocity acceleration is function of r. You cannot solve this using the normal integration. So what we do is that, okay, this is again rewrite the same thing. Instead of multiplying dt both sides, I multiply dr both sides by some unknown reason. But it will give you the solution. So I multiply dr both sides, dr dot dt, same as before. I multiply dr here, r multiplied by dr. This is okay, perfectly okay. I just multiply dr both sides. Yeah? I swap this dr dot and dr. Dr first, dr dot later. Nothing changed. What is this? This is velocity, r dot. So r dot, dr dot, r, dr. So everything is matched now. This is r dot, integration variable is r dot. This is r, integration variable is r. So now I put the integration, both sides. Now I put the boundary condition. Because this is integration variable, is r, therefore should be r. I pick the time at t equal to 0. R0 was half meter. When it exits, r time I don't know yet. Let's call it t star. That t star is the when the particle exits the pipe. Okay, t star we don't know, but r we know. When it exits, it's a one meter. Yeah, it should be one. Left hand side. Now you have to match the boundary condition to the right hand side. So this is the velocity r dot, therefore in boundary should be, condition should be velocity at time t equal to 0 should be matched with the other side. Velocity, I assume that this is initially 0, and r dot at t star, that's what we want to calculate. What's the velocity when it exits? Yeah. So far, so good. Yeah. So okay. R dot integrated by dr dot is. Yes, it's r dot square divided by 2, replaced by 0, and r dot at t star is equal to again r. Integration by dr is r square over 2 replaced by half and 1. Right hand side, you left hand side, you got r dot squared at t star when it exits divided by 2 minus 0 is 0, so I don't need it. The other side, 1 over 2 minus 1 over 2 square gives you 1 over 4 divided by 2 gives you 1 over 8. This is the 1 over 2 minus 1 over 8 is 3 over 8. Now I'll do square when it exits. It's 3 over 8. Therefore, R dot at T star when it exits, the square root of 3 over 8 plus minus.
Is that 3 over
4? Something's wrong?
3 over
4. Is it 3 over 4? Oh, yeah, yes, yes, 2. Yes, that's right. 4. 4. So this is plus minus square root 3. Divided by 2 to meter per sec, but it will be positive direction because when it exits, going back to the original drawing, when it exits, velocity in this direction will be this way. That's the positive IB direction here. That's the positive IB direction, therefore it should be positive. Therefore, you have to pick R dot T star is square root of 3 divided by 2 meter per sec. I can also ask the what's the F var at axis. F wall from the first second equation, that's 2 R dot here. Therefore, this is 2 R dot at T star, which is square root of 3. What's the unit? Yes, Newton. So, as I just demonstrated for both using the two examples, most of the time what you have to do is that you have to establish this equation of motion, the second order ordinary differential equation using the Newton's second law. And then using the given conditions, you just integrate twice. And then there will be some unknowns, which are the one that I usually ask. Or the you have the quantity you want to find out. I can make this problem a little bit more complicated, like this. Actually, this is one of my exam problems when I finished my PhD degree. We have some oral exam at the end of the PhD degree, so. The usually professor came and then they give the problem, ask you to solve in the blackboard. So this is the one of the problems that he asked. So exactly same problem like this, but I'm adding one more coordinate. So now pipe looks like this, and it rotates. And you have a particle here. And of course, gravitational acceleration acting this way. I mean, if you're looking at from the top, then it's the exactly the same problem that we just solved. Then the this case, you can make it complicated, looks complicated at the beginning, like drawing this picture and asking that, all, given the all the initial condition, angular velocity like that, and then asking that when after it exits, from the top, you can see that this is pipe, here's, and at a certain point it exits, velocity like this, and flying somewhere, and then landed. So it's flying somewhere, and landed somewhere here. Then you can ask the if this is the x and y coordinates, where is this coordinates when the particle landed? Yeah. Well, this looks complicated, but if you solve this problem from the top, this is the problem that we just solved, and then you can calculate the velocity at the end, exit point, and then from there, it's just the initial velocity with the free fall, with the gravitational force. Then you solve the another set of equation, then you calculate where it lands. So, dynamics is it's not the content is not complicated. You already know all the stuff. The only capability you have to acquire during this course is that some kind of insight or instinct to decouple this looks complicated problem to the simpler one. In this case, you can decouple this problem in two sets. Then it looks simpler. Then you can solve it. Okay. Before I close the today's session, now you have I think some group already finished the lab session. Lab session is about the double pendulum oscillation. You may think that the double pendulum looks too simple, but it has a lot of applications, more than that you can imagine. For example, human arm is double pendulum. Basically, this is one joint here, and there's another joint here. So this is basically a double pendulum. Also human leg as well. So when you want to design the robot to working, humanoid robot, you need to understand this double pendulum dynamics. Okay, so it has a lot of implications. So. Okay, I'll see you in the next week.